Batman has a Batmobile. What do you expect the Weedman to have? The Weedmobile. In 2008, I got this tan 1986 Ford Echoline E150. And I wanted it to be the Liberty Bell Temple's temple van, like a church van, but a temple van. And I met this kid named Justin Perry, AKA The Butcher. He was a graffiti artist from Echo Park, and he used to come into my shop all the time. So one day I asked him, hey, can you make my Weedmobile like just stand out? I said, just paint it up, just graffiti it. I said, what I wanted it to say, it had to have number 420 on it. I wanted to have church symbols on it, religious symbols with weed, and I wanted an image of me blowing smoke in Uncle Sam's face. And he made a masterpiece. The Weedmobile became an instant success. All over Hollywood, people noticed it. I used it every day to drive back and forth to the temple. I gave my employees a couple of dollars for gas and would send them out with flyers all over Hollywood. I mean, it became a tourist attraction. People took pictures of it. But the greatest thing was when I put it in this video, this music video called One Bud by Hawk. Check this out. Weedmobile became so instrumental in my promotions. You know, in 2008 I created NJWEEDMAN'S Promotions, and the star of it was the Weedmobile. I mean, we used the Weedmobile to promote parties, to promote events. I mean, we started having these big mansion parties up in the Hollywood Hills. And it was the Weedmobile that was instrumental in that. '09, 2010, and '11 were great years for me out in Los Angeles. But in 2010, on April 1st, I actually flew home and I got busted in Jersey. And for all of 2010, 2011, I talked about how I was going to go home to New Jersey and I was going to whoop the prosecutor's butt. I compared myself to General MacArthur, and I said, I will return. And that's what I did in the Weedmobile. I drove across the country. I made a documentary about it. It's on YouTube called For NJWEEDMAN'S Road Entry. In this war on drugs, I basically got chased out of New Jersey and I came here to California. But when I left New Jersey, I said, I'll be back. I'm coming back. I'm gonna whoop some ass. This I'm going to call my rudimentary jury nullification trial. And what I plan on doing is going from city to city, from here to New Jersey. When I leave Los Angeles, my first stop is going to be Las Vegas. My second stop will be Denver. My third stop will be Kansas City, Kansas. In St. Louis, Missouri, Indianapolis, Indiana, Cincinnati, Ohio, Akron, Ohio, Carlisle, Pennsylvania, and finally Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, before I cross into New Jersey on April 1st.
Open up your mind and meditate with me. TV, entertainment for the cannabis community.
Hey, if Batman can have a Batmobile, the Weedman has the Weedmobile.
The self-proclaimed New Jersey Weedman is back in Burlington County with his Weedmobile that he just drove across country from California. Ed Fortune is trying to bring attention to his drug possession trial, in which he's being charged with having marijuana in his car that he legally got from California. Now, even though his trial has been postponed, Fortune is hoping to represent himself and ask jurors to set the law aside and consider if marijuana should be legal in the Garden State.
I had a pound of marijuana, and a pound of marijuana to me is nothing more than a carton of cigarettes to someone who smokes cigarettes, basically about the same amount of weight. The marijuana was medical marijuana for my own medical problems. I wasn't selling it. It was mine. My medicine was legal in California. I came to New Jersey, and I got arrested for it. And I think that's wrong and unjust, a misapplication of the law. And I know the jurors are empowered to say not guilty. I almost feel that I'm conviction proof. I feel that in any setting, there's always a closet pothead. I'm hoping to get one on my jury. Marijuana has always been good to me. Marijuana has always made me feel normal. Why pop a Tylenol when I can twist one up and smoke it all? What would you say if you were on my jury?
Now, it's unclear yet if the Weedman's defense will actually hold up in court or whether a judge will allow it. The trial is expected to begin next month. Now, whether you agree with him or not, his case has caught national attention.
And that rudimentary was cool. As I went across the country, I stopped and I met all these people, like, in the Weedmobile. Like, that's why I posted things like, hey, I need gas, I need this, I need that, you know, the Weedmobile. I was PayPaling across the country, and it worked. Got back to New Jersey. You know, I got press and publicity in New Jersey. Then I went to trial, and I won. I actually have a medical marijuana card from the state of California, and I don't understand why New Jersey not only has not enforced its own medical marijuana law, but you know, it doesn't allow people from other states to come in and still be protected legally. And that's what this case is about. And hopefully, my jury is going to find me not guilty of bringing my own medicine from California to... I'm extremely happy, not guilty. I mean, 2.5 years and I got 12-0. You know, I said I only needed one, I got 12.
And I think that other patients should argue the same points, that the law is wrong. That my jury heard that. My jury understood that. My jury came in with their own conscience, utilized their own conscience, and rendered a decision. You know?
You have to present a huge message to the state, to Governor Christie, to the prosecutor's office here. And what I'm hoping is defendant after defendant comes in and wants to utilize the same type of defense. I hope they even call it the Weedman defense. I hope. I got found not guilty. I drove the Weedmobile back to California.
And then I had to drive it back a few months later when things didn't work out in California. And then I started all over in Trenton. And then the funny thing is, after I got back, I mean, I did numerous interviews in the Weedmobil. Jeff Edelstein from the Trentonian. A Star Ledger reporter, a Burlington County Times reporter, a columnist, J.D. Mullaney from Bucks County in Pennsylvania.
The Trentonian. We are live on Trentonian TV. We are in, what is this called?
The Weedmobil.
And who are we with?
The one and only world famous superhero to the potheads. New Jersey Weedman.
Hello, and thanks for joining us here in Trenton, New Jersey. I'm Enrique Levine of NJ Advanced Media, sitting in the Weedmobil with NJ Weedman.
And even I encountered the governor, and I stalked the governor in it. And the governor gave a press conference about it a couple days later. Like, the Weedmobil became legendary.
Mr. Christie, how are you?
I'm good.
This is the Weed Man. I tracked you down again. Hey, if Batman has a Batmobile, shouldn't Weed Man have a Weedmobile? I hear you. Well, Mr. Christie, when are you going to stop arresting people for marijuana, though? Having people arrested for marijuana?
You know now. I haven't arrested anybody. I don't get to do that anymore.
But the prosecutor's office, our state laws still say marijuana is illegal, a Schedule I drug. And 22,000 people got arrested for marijuana last year.
Weedman, by the way, so does the federal government.
I would like to call President Obama. Can you get me a meeting with Mr. Obama, please?
Why don't you bring the weed truck out in front of the White House?
I've done that before, but I tell you what, you're his buddy.
Like this.
All right. Listen, I like you though.
I know.
You should stop arresting people though.
I just staked out the governor. I got the governor. And he talked. He called me Weedman. I don't know how much you can see it here, but hey. There he goes. Oh, well. There goes the governor.
In fact, I was doing my radio show Monday night. And after I left the studios in Ewing, outside in a van, was my old friend, the Weed Man. Weed Man, old Ed. He's been picketing me since 2002. Ed used to come when he was less famous, down to my office in Newark in the Rodino building on Broad Street in Newark, and by himself would picket me. And I would walk outside to walk to lunch, and old Ed would be out there, and we'd chat, and Ed would continue to advocate for his position, and I'd walk over to lunch, and when I'd walk back, Ed'd still be there, carrying his picket sign with my picture on it, telling me I shouldn't arrest people anymore for marijuana violations. And so it's stunning to me, it really was stunning to me. Now, Ed's really gotten famous, he's got his own van, right? Maybe I've seen it, he's got, you know, it's all, I don't know where it's getting the money. Maybe people who have my old job should take a look at that. But it's not only equipped and put together detailed on the outside, but it's also got a speaker system. So I walked out of the radio station and over this loudspeaker, not knowing where it was coming from. I said, "Governor, it's me, your old friend, the Weed Man. Please stop arresting people for marijuana." He said, "I don't do that anymore. May have missed the papers, I'm governor now." And we had a back and forth as I was getting in the car. Troopers made sure he stayed in the van.
And
I even made a couple spoof videos, like, of the governor in the Weedmobile. Check this one.
For real, it's Governor Christie. Hello? Of course it's me. Come pick me up at my mansion. I got the munchy foods. Where the hell is Weed Man? I thought he'd be here by now. I got us some munchy food, Weed Man.
I got some munchy makers.
Ha!
Come on, go. Hang out.
About ready to have a ball.
Governor, why would you go on national TV, do a press conference to tell the world that I'm your good friend after you had me arrested for protesting you outside your office in Newark?
Ed, I told you. I can't sleep. I can't eat. I can't even think straight no more. I didn't know what else to say. Who knew they were going to bring up you in my press conferences?
You know what I say? That sounds like stress to me. You know what I say? Smoke some marijuana, Governor.
Is it medical?
Yeah, it's medical. It's all medical.
You gonna drive me back to my house when I'm done?
Of course I'll drive you back.
You won't tell any of the state troopers if they ask?
I won't tell nobody.
You won't write about it in your column?
No.
Do I have your word?
You got my word.
Only because you, I consider my friend.
Your friend.
After all these years of you chasing me down, after all those joints you sent in my mailbox.
Yeah, whatever happened to those joints that I mailed?
I gave them to security.
Security? So somebody on your staff, the security staff, smokes weed?
No, not at all.
Oh, they destroyed it?
No, we had it tested and made sure your fingerprints were on it.
Come on, Gov. Just like a stogie, you know? I know you and Rush Limbaugh smoked those big stogies, so go for it.
I can't breathe, Ed.
You'll be all right. You'll be all right. Just relax. You'll relax. Some people get paranoid the first time they smoke it. You might be a little paranoid. Don't worry about it. By next week... you'll be okay. Munchie maker, munchie food.
Munchie maker, munchie food. I had about 10 million donuts. But this is the best jelly donut ever. Look at all the sugar on it. Look at all the jelly in it. I love you.
You feeling good, man?
Yeah. Let's go to McDonald's next. Yeah, man. Let's go.
Yo, let's go visit Mary Pat Angelini.
You know, the Weedmobile became such a symbol. I mean, I just left it parked in front of the joint. And just like in Hollywood, it just became that little tourist attraction. It became the best advertisement I had. You know, people would look at the Weedmobile, they'd take pictures of the place, and they would come in. And anyway, I got into a pissing contest basically with a Lieutenant Gonzalez in January or February of 2016, and it became a pissing contest. And at some point, like, they towed the Weedmobile, and then I got.
This is the harassment I'm getting. This
this is what happens when you just try to be free.
They done towed away the motherfucking Weedmobil. You sons of bitches done towed away the motherfucking Weedmobil.
And then I got it back, and I put it in the backyard, which isn't even my property, but I put it in the backyard. And then on April 27th, they raided us. And when they raided us, they gave me a piece of paper saying that the Weedmobil was being held for an asset forfeiture hearing. But they didn't tell that to Hawk's Tow in the impound yard. Hawk's Tow, I guess, assumed I abandoned it. And after I didn't come pick it up after 30 days, they stripped it, crushed it, made it into a little box, a little cube of scrap metal. And, you know, and here is the last known video of the Weedmobil at our cannabis bash on April 18th.
I was in NJ, now today I'm in FLA, M-I-A-M-I, in NJ, looking people in the eye, cause M-I-A-M-I, Mary Jane, and music is medicine, playing for the crop, now you.
You know, and as it is now, it's like rest in peace. I mean, the Weedmobil crisscrossed the country several times. The Weedmobil served this purpose. I mean, I am the weed man, and I should have a Weedmobil, just like Batman has a Batmobile. So that's my mission for 2017, to get a new Weedmobil. And on a side note, I appeared in Trentonian so much that at some point I even got a job as a columnist there. And even there, my picture, my image, was of the Weedmobil and me standing in front of the Trentonian. And after the raid, I not only lost the Weedmobil, but I lost my gig at the Trentonian. I'm no longer at the Trentonian.